Hello dear students, a very good morning to all of you. Dear children, in today's video we will discuss the factors on which ionic bond depends. Okay, so our today's topic is factors on which ionic bond depends. So first factor is low ionization enthalpy. So dear students, as we know about the ionic compound, that in ionic compound, one of the atom must form a cation, okay? And what is the ionization enthalpy? Ionization enthalpy is the energy required to form a cation, okay? So if this electropositive part has low value of ionization enthalpy, what does it mean? It means that it will form the cation very easily. And if cation will form easily, automatically ionic bond will form easily, okay? So we can say that lesser the value of ionization enthalpy, greater will be the tendency to form cation, and greater is the possibility to form ionic bond, okay? Now if we talk about the elements which has the low value of ionization enthalpy, then the elements present in first group and second group in periodic table, I am talking about alkali metals and alkaline earth metal. They have the low values of ionization enthalpy, so definitely they have the greater tendency to form ionic compounds, okay? So group 1 and group 2 element will form the ionic compound dominantly, okay? Now we'll talk about the second factor. Second factor is high electron gain enthalpy. So in ionic compound, if we talk about the other part, so other part must form anion, okay? And what is electron gain enthalpy? Electron gain enthalpy is the enthalpy change when anion is formed, okay? So if it has high value of electron gain enthalpy, it means it will change into anion very easily, okay? And similarly, if anion will form easily, then ionic bond will form easily, okay? So we can say greater the value of electron gain enthalpy, greater will be the tendency to form anion, and greater will be the chance to form ionic bond, okay? Now let's talk about the elements. So the elements of group 16 and 17 has the very high values of electron gain enthalpy, so definitely they have the high chance to form ionic compounds, ionic bonds. So group 16 and 17 elements, okay? Let's move towards the third factor. Third factor is lattice enthalpy. First of all, you should know lattice enthalpy. What is lattice enthalpy? So lattice enthalpy is the energy which evolved in the formation of ionic compound, okay? You can see by this equation, suppose M is the cation in gaseous state and X is the anion also in gaseous state, and they are combining together and form MX, an ionic compound, and the energy evolved in this procedure is known as lattice enthalpy, okay? So lattice enthalpy is nothing but the energy evolved in the formation of ionic compound from these anion and cation in gaseous state. Okay, so if the value of lattice enthalpy is higher, it means the cation and anion will have the lower value in this compound. Okay, means they will packed in this compound very strongly. Okay, so definitely higher lattice enthalpy, the higher value of lattice enthalpy favors the formation of ionic bond. Okay, so this is the third factor. Now we'll talk about the fourth factor is difference in electronegativities. So if the, as we know that ionic compounds form by the transfer of electron. Okay, so transfer of electron is possible only when the electron, when the difference in electronegativities of these two cation anion is large. Okay, only then electron can be transferred from one atom to another. Okay, so it is very easy to say that large difference of electronegativity will favor the formation of ionic bond. Okay, so these are the four factors on which the formation of ionic bond depends. Thank you.